Assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to discuss about flannel board. Flannel graph is storytelling system that uses a board covered with a flannel fabric, usually resting on an easel. It is very similar to fuzzy felt, and although its primary use is a storytelling medium rather than as a toy. Flannel board is sometimes called a flannel graph, visual board, flip board, slab board, fat board, and choreograph, videograph, etc. If we define this flannel board, then this is a display made up of wood, cardboard, or straw board covered with a color flannel or wooden cloth. According to homology, con flannel or felt board is a rigid surface covered with a cotton flannel, wool terry cloth, or felt cloth. Its principle is that flannel board always uses the adhesive qualities of interlocking hairs of the suitable material to enable pictures and cord back with these to be fixed to a board covered with a cloth of similar material, simply by exercising gentle pressure. It has some purposes, like to enable the teachers develop an idea step by step in many dramatic and impressive manner, then to add variety to the classroom activities, to provide information and motivation to the learner. It conveys ideas more expressively, and the broaden sensory experiences of the learner, and it educates both illiterate and literate people, and to present an idea in the more appealing way to the children. It has some uses, like the teacher adheres various pictures on the flannel board along with the commentary of descriptions. It is used for recognition and work formation during the language teaching in primary classes. It can be used for recognition and recall testing. Flannel graph is useful in teaching elementary lessons on numbers. It is of a great help in playing educative puzzles and show interrelationship between different parts of process. So these are different types of flannels that being used. It has different types, like hygiene type. This flannel graph does not have support. It has to hang on the wall surface to adhere material. And the second one is self-supporting flannel graph. It has a support and usually made up of wood, and it can be placed without support of wall or surface on its own stand. Like here, see that it has no support. These are just for hanging purpose. Now, how can we prepare? Number one is that materials are board made of plywood or hardwood or thick cardboard. Its size may be 120 into 80 cm. This board is cut and edges are smoothed. Cloth. Flannel or felt material is used, or dark color must be used. Secured on the board with pins, glues or staples, and that cloth, if the flannel is spread over the board evenly, without wrinkles and secured. Wrinkles means that it shouldn't have some time of gathered cloth. Cut out our pictures, pins or staples to fix flannel cloths, or glue or adhesive cloths, and substitutes for these articles. You have substitutes, like woolen cloths can be used instead of flannel cloth, or sandpaper cloths, welcome stickers can be used to stick the cutout. Then preparation steps. How can we prepare? Like first of all, gather all the articles. Then the board is cut and its edges are smoothed. Then the board is folded in the middle to make it portable. Then flannel cloth is spread on the board without wrinkles and secured up with pens, glues and staples. And then an adhesive material or glued sand can be put on back sides of the cutouts, and then it is pressed on the flannel graph as desired sequence. using a flannel graphs. So if you are using a flannel graphs, then black pictures, cutouts or light objects, and back them with a sandpaper piece. Keep all sets of flannel graphs materials in the separate clearly marked envelopes, and plan before the lessons as to where each piece will be placed on black cloth. Then average the pieces in exact order in which they will be used. Place the flannel graph at backward slant 10 to 15 degree so that pictures will not fall, and build up scenes and illustrate points as they occur in the study, and then change the picture or cut out as you talk to students. Then it's aim to conclude the talk with the picture or arrangement that will leave the lasting impression on the students. Replace the pieces in the envelope at the end of the lessons like this. So these type of pictures having some impact on the students. There are some guidelines that the content of the board should be organized and around the central theme. Appearance must be neat and orderly, and the material should be displayed in an attractive manner. Avoid overcrowding on the board. It should be clearly seen by the group members, and the display pictures should be sufficiently large in size, and remove the picture as soon as these purposes are over. Like this, you can see that this board has very clear pictures. Everything is clear. Now there are some advantages of flannel graphs. It is inexpensive, easily made from locally available material, and flannel graphs hold the attention of the audience, and it is ideal for exhibiting the dramatic storytelling. It can be easily maintained and carried to remote areas. On flannel graph, figures can be used in different presentations. It ideal for showing if events, and it can be adopted for group participations, and the display materials can be changed without use of drawing pins or paste. And there are some disadvantages of flannel graphs, like it requires a considerable advanced preparations, and if pictures are not properly placed, so it may fall in between. And efficient use of flannel graphs requires much practice. Artistic abilities needed. You must be artistic in handling such type of pictures, and limited audience can only be accommodated. So we can conclude that a flannel graph is a type of visual display aid made of wood, cardboard, or covered with a flannel cloth to display cut boards or pictures on it simply by applying pressures. Use of flannel graph serves variety of purposes and education, and it has several advantages. It is inexpensive and can be prepared in local settings. Flannel graphs is useful visual aids, and if used effectively and skillfully, it can be helped in nursing education in both theoretical and clinical settings. Thank you so much for being with me. Take care. Allah Hafiz.